Alhamdulillahi Rabbil Alameen Wa salatu wa salamu ala ashrafil mursalin Sayyidina wa nabiyyina wa maulana Muhammadin Sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa sallam Wa ala alihi wa ashabihi ajma'in Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh When the prophethood of our Nabi Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was announced, it brought about such a revolution which changed the world forever. And we're still feeling its effects up till today, subhanAllah. And it will be felt right up till Yawm al-Qiyamah. Allah says in the Quran about it, it says, قل بعد أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم الله تعالى رسول صلى الله عليه وسلم قل say to them يا أيها الناس أو people إني رسول الله إليكم جميعا I have been sent to you all as a messenger of Allah. With this declaration it has become binding on all humanity to accept him as Allah's messenger and to obey him. May Allah make us of those, Ya Allah. مَنْ يُطِعِ الرَّسُولِ فَقَدْ عَطَعَ اللَّهِ He who obeys the messenger has verily obeyed Allah. وَمَنْ تَوَلَّ And the one who turns away, فَمَا أَرْسَلْنَاكَ عَلَيْهِمْ حَفِيظًا Verily, Ya Rasulullah, we have not sent you as a watcher over them. Stern talk. His role has been made clear. وَمَا أَرْسَلْنَاكَ إِلَّا كَافَةً لِلنَّاسِ بَشِيرًا وَنَذِيرًا And we have not sent you, Ya Muhammad, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, to all mankind, except as a giver of glad tidings and a warner. وَلَكِنْ أَكْثَرَ النَّاسِ لَا يَعْلَمُونَ But most of the people do not know. They don't want to know, Ya Allah. Today we find ourselves, the 12th of Rabi'ul Awwal, there is Ikhtilaf, there's difference of opinion about by the historians that some say it is the 9th, some say it's the 8th, some say it's the 12th, the Shia says it's the 17th, and it carries on and on. But one thing for certain, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam has been born and was born on a Monday because the hadith confirms that when they ask Rasul sallallahu alaihi wasallam why is he fasting on a Monday, he said, because I was born. Celebrating his birth, in other words. So, we can celebrate his birth every day of our lives. But we need one formal, like we've taken 12 of Rabiul Awwal, for whatever reason. It's a beautiful day or night to get together, and we have to see the children. I've been visiting last night various different masjids, which I was invited to, and see how the children were enjoying themselves, exposed to the history of our Nabi Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, Sira, beautiful qasida were being recited, and the children, they have comfort, they enjoy that. Let them grow up in that. Don't let them grow up into Michael Jackson. Let them grow up into Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. The alternatives are horrendous because we live in a non-Muslim society. So our challenges are huge and humongous. Can you imagine our generation? And it's been reported that each generation will become weaker and weaker. And it's happening. We're seeing that in our community. But let me go back. When Allah created the light, the Nur al-Muhammadiyya, and He ordered him to look at all the other lights of the other prophets. And his light covered them. And Allah had them talk. And they said, Oh our Lord, who is covering us with the light? Or with his light? And Allah replied, this is Muhammad ibn Abdullah. If you believe in him, I will make all of you prophets. Subhanallah. And they also replied, in the Alami Arwah, we believe in him and we believe in his prophethood. And Allah says, shall I be your witness? And look what Allah says in the Quran. وَإِذْ أَخَذَ اللَّهُ مِيثَاقَ النَّبِيِّينَ لَمَا آتَيْتُكُم مِّن كِتَابٍ وَحِكْمَةٍ. And remember when Allah took the covenant of the prophets, saying, take whatever I gave you from the book and wisdom. ثُمَّ جَاءَكُمْ رَسُولٌ مُصَدِّقٌ لِمَا مَعَكُمْ لَتُؤْمِنُنَّ بِهِ وَلَتَنْصُرُنَّهُ. And afterwards, says Allah, there will come to you a messenger confirming what is with you. And you must then believe in him. And you must help him. قال, and Allah says, أَأَقْرَرْتُمْ? Do you agree with it? وَأَخَذْتُمْ عَلَىٰ ذَٰلِكُمْ إِصْرِي. And when you take up my covenant, which I conclude with you. قَالُوا أَقْرَرْنَا. And they all answered, we agree. And then Allah says, قَالَ فَاشْهَدُوا وَأَنَا مَعَكُمْ مِنَ الشَّاهِدِينَ. He then says, Allah says, then bear witness. And I am with you among the witnesses for this. So we move on. This has happened in the Alami Arwah in another dimension. And Allah records this in the Quran. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam's birth was amazing. Ibn Abbas radiallahu anhu said that Sayyidina Amina used to relate, an angel came to me in a dream during my 6 months of pregnancy and said to me, oh Amina, you are pregnant with the best of the worlds. When you give birth to him, name him Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and keep it a secret. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam's blessed mother, Amina, relates, at the time, and I quote, I was ready to give birth. There was no one with me, neither man or no woman attended me, for everyone, including Abdul Muttalib, had gone to make tawaf of the Kaaba. I was all alone in the house, and suddenly there was a noise and I felt great fear. And then I saw what looked like a wing of a bird, a white bird, appear, rubbing my chest, causing all fear to subside. And every pain I was feeling disappeared. Subhanallah. A white drink was handed to me, which I drank, after which a bright light fell upon me, and I was surrounded by some women, tall as palm trees, who looked like the women of Abdelmalaf. I was amazed, thinking, how did they find me? How did they know about me? And while I was pondering the question, in my heart, one of the ladies spoke and said, I am Hawa, the wife of Ibrahim. One said, I am Hajar, the wife of Nabi Ibrahim. Hawa, the wife of Nabi Adam, of course. Another one said, I am Asiya, wife of Fir'aun. Another one said, I am Maryam, daughter of Imran and mother of Isa. And the others were introduced as the houris of paradise, the women of paradise, subhanAllah. And they all had come to usher our Nabi Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam into this earthly life. And they assisted at the birth of the blessed Nabi. And I, says Amina, suffered neither pain nor any trouble. And when I looked again, I saw the child was circumcised, and that his umbilical cord was cut, and he was wrapped in a piece of white cloth. He touched the ground with his blessed head, says his Imam. And he lifted the forefinger of his right hand and he made a dua to Allah. And Sidna Amina says, I bent down to listen. And this is what I heard. Ashhadu an la ilaha illallah wa inni rasulullah. Allahu akbar kabira. Walhamdulillahi kathira. Wa subhanallahi bukratan wa asila. Allahumma ummati ummati. Subhanallah. Al-Khatib al-Baghdadi narrating another riwayah. That Sayyidina Amina says, when I gave birth to Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, I saw a large illuminated cloud wherein I heard horses neighing, wings flapping, and men or people talking. It covered him and he disappeared from my sight, says Sayyidina Amina. Then I heard a voice calling, take Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam all over the earth, show him to every being, spiritual, jinn, human beings, angels, birds, and wild beasts. Give him the shape of Adam, the knowledge of Seth, the courage of Noah, the intimacy of Ibrahim, the tongue of Ismail, the contentment of Ishaq, the eloquence of Saleh, the wisdom of Lot, the glad tidings of Yaqub, the strength of Musa, the patience of Ayyub, the obedience of Yunus, the strife of Yusha, the protection of Dawood, the love of Daniel, the reverence of Ilyas, the impeccability of Yohanna, in other words, John the Baptist, and the asceticism of Isa, alayhi salam, Allah be pleased with all of them, and immerse him in the qualities of the prophets. The very prophet that has been mentioned, subhanAllah, was also related by Ibn Abbas. The night the Holy Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was born, all the idols from the Kaaba fell from the places and they broke to pieces, subhanAllah. All created beings other than mankind, they were rejoicing. They were giving each other glad tidings. They were saying, oh Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, may Allah make you happy and always pleased. For there is no creature born with greater honor than you, and none that is more excellent. Never had the angels celebrated the birth of any created being as they now celebrate your birth into this world. Subhanallah. The grandfather of our Nabi Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was at the Kaaba when Sidna Amina gave birth, and she sent him word of this glad event, inviting him to come and see her newborn son. And Abdul Muttalib relates, he says, I was at a time within the building of the Kaaba, and there I witnessed how the walls of the building themselves began to shake and tremble with joy, calling out to each other, the Lord Almighty has bestowed great honor on us that we might see the coming of the Prophet who will cleanse us of the filth of these idols. Abdul Muttalib says, I was amazed at hearing this, and I understood then that we must have given birth, and that these words heralded the importance of the child we have given birth to. Sidna Amina reports, she says, later when he looked upon my son Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said, praise be to the all-powerful Lord that he has granted me such an auspicious grandchild. And he praised him with great many praises. As you know, the Arabs love reciting poetry. It was quite natural for them. While from the child's blessed body, such a beautiful scent filled the whole town of Makkah, as if with the fragrance of musk and amber. Subhanallah. These are all the miraculous aspects that took place. Voices of praise and rejoicing were heard throughout the town. even to the house of Abu Lahab, the uncle of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. While he was laying asleep, voices from the unseen filled his room, and the smell of musk and amber pervaded the air. From this, he awoke. This is Abu Lahab. He was greatly perplexed now. And the slave girl, Thuwaiba, who was lying next to him, he turns to her and says, "What is making all these strange sounds?" And Thuwaiba says, "Good news and tidings to you of joy, O Abu Lahab. Your brother Abdullah's wife Amina has given birth to a son, Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. The sound you hear are the voices of those who inhabit the regions between heaven and earth, heralding the birth of this miraculous child." Abu Lahab was so pleased at the news that was given to him. He says to Thuwaiba, "Ya Thuwaiba, for that you have given me joyful tidings, I shall give you your freedom. Go to the house of the mother of Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam and offer your services as a wet nurse, for you too are a nursing a child called Masruj." So Thuwaiba went and became also a wet nurse for Nabi Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. For 7 days his mother Amina gave him milk. After that, Thuwaiba came and nursed him until he was given to Halimatu Sa'diyah. It is related that some people saw Abu Lahab in their dreams after he died. Remember, although he was the uncle of Nabi Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, as he was growing up, he loved the child as a baby. But as he grew up, and at 40 when he announced his nubuwah, announced his prophethood, Abu Lahab became his vehement enemy. So, and when he died, and he died in that state. So many people, pious people, ordinary people, were dreaming about Abu Lahab after he had died. And when they asked him, "How is he doing in the afterlife?" And he answers, he says, "Woe to me. Was I not the uncle of a great and distinguished prophet? If I had believed in him, I would have become one of the blissful dwellers of paradise and the gardens in paradise. But I chose to be his greatest enemy, persisting in error and disbelief, so that now I am one of the damned ones in hell. However, there are two grants of mercy that I receive over and above all the other inmates of Jahannam. And from the night linking Sunday to Monday up to the following night, my punishment is alleviated, made much less." And this, he continues, he says, "When I place my two fingers in my mouth, on that day a cool drink of water comes forth between my index and my middle fingers that soothes my punishment." Hafiz Shamsuddin Muhammad ibn Nasiruddin al-Dimashqi, he writes on this about the following verses in his book, Mawlidu Sa'adi. He says, "If this, a kafir who was condemned to hell eternally, was tabbat yada abi lahab wa tab, perish you with both hands, O Abu Lahab," because he told Nabi Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, just digressing, when Nabi Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam called them together, and it's mentioned in the Quran, he says, when Nabi Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, Quraysh, busy coming to attack you, what is Abu Lahab says? "You call us for this? May you perish." And Allah revealed this beautiful surah. "May you perish, Abu Lahab." SubhanAllah. So He says, if this kafir who was condemned to hell eternally with perish his hands, is said to enjoy a relief every Monday because he rejoiced in Ahmad, what then do you think of the servant who all his life was happy with Ahmad and died saying Ahad? Subhanallah. So we find so many miracles that took place. Do you think our Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam came into this world unannounced? Oh no. Had an effect all over the world. Some of the miracles that took place, incidences in Persia, for example, at the time of his birth, it said the fire in the temple of the Zoroastrians, which had been alight for thousands of years, became doused and quenched for the first time in history. There were 14 towers of the royal palace. The emperor of Persia, it broke and it fell. The famous stone on which the famous throne of Persia was kept, it cracked. The fast-flowing river of Saba in the Persian Empire, it dried up. The river Samawa in the Persian Empire, which had been dry for 1,000 years, it started flowing immediately. The tower of the palace on the river Tigris, which was built so strongly that nothing could damage it for hundreds of years, it broke and it fell. These were all the signs that the Nabi Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was coming. In Yemen, they left a man called Amr, who was praying with his wife to the idol. And then the idol in front of him fell on his face. And as he went to lift up the idol, it reported, the promised prophet whose coming was being looked forward to for hundreds of years has just been born. The trees and the stones shall speak for him. For his sake, the moon will split in two. Amr had a handicapped, deformed daughter. And she was seeing all this and hearing all this. And she made this dua. Oh, my Lord, in the name of Muhammad, who had just been born, I pray that I be cured. And at once she was completely cured. Subhanallah. Subhanallah. It is said they were so impressed that they went to go find out who, with the parents, all of them went. Amr went. Eventually they met up with the Nabi Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Subhanallah. And it's been reported that he collapsed out of ecstasy on seeing the face of Nabi Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And that was the time of his ajal and he died. Subhanallah. In Rome, so many things happened as well. The Roman emperor was surprised to find that the statue of Jesus Christ had very strangely come out from its firm base and was lying on the ground. And it reminded him what Nabi Isa predicted. He says, on the day of the birth of the promised prophet, all idols, all over the world would fall down. And as he lifted up the statue again, it fell down on him. And it declared, a child has been born with his foreskin circumcised miraculously. This child would be the greatest personage to come on earth and who would be from amongst the circumcised people. Subhanallah. This baby was not from a Jewish family, but from the brethren of the Jews. He would be a destroyer of idols and would lay the foundation for the destruction of idolatry. Those who would not listen to his teachings would be losers in this earth and in the hereafter. He would be the light of learning, which would be the cause of filling the earth with wisdom and knowledge and removing darkness and ignorance. وَقُلْ جَاءَ الْحَقُّ وَذَهَبَ الْبَاطِلُ. Truth has arrived and falsehood has been destroyed. That was the advent and welcome that was given to our Nabi Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Subhanallah. So many riwayats have been written. So many sayings have been said. In Cape Town, for centuries, we have been reciting the Maulud Barzanji, Wahanallah. Even last night, we were reciting parts of it, just to say a few and translate. Because many times we just hear and we know it off by heart, but we don't know what has been recited. It says, وَلَمَّا تَمَّ مِنْ حَمْلِهِ شَهْرَانِ عَلَى مَشْهُورِ الْأَقْوَالِ الْمَرْوِيَّةِ Allah. What does it say? See, while his mother was 2 months pregnant with him, according to the most famous narration, تُوفِيَ بِالْمَدِينَةِ الْمُنَوَّرَةِ أَبُوهُ عَبْدُ اللَّهِ This is the tune that we have inherited for literally centuries. So what did he say? His father Abdullah passed away in Medina while traveling through on a journey from Syria. وَكَانَ مَدِيَّةَ زَمِ أَخْوَانِهِ بَنِي عَدِيٍّ مِنَ الطَّائِفَةِ النَّجَارِيَّةِ وَمَكَثَ فِيهِمْ شَهْرًا سَقِيمًا يُعَانُونَ سُقْمَهُ وَشَكْوًا He says, he stayed with his maternal uncles, known as Bani Ali from the Najariya tribe, for a full month. The riwayah says, they tried their best to relieve Abdullah from his sickness, but he died. ولما تم من حمله على الراجح 19 قمرية وأنا للزمان أن ينجلي عنه صدى When Amina was 9 months pregnant according to the most famous narrations and the time was approaching that the first of the universe should be quenched with the blessed arrival حضر أمه ليلة مولده آسية ومريم في نسوة من الحظيرة القدسية آسية and مريم and pure and chaste ladies from the heavens were present to attend to his birth. وَأَخَذَا الْمَخَاضُ فَوَلَدَتْهُ صَلَّى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمَ نُورَيَّةَ لَهْلَهُ سَبْحَانَ اللَّهُ She, Amina, gave birth to him, and there came out the brightest of light, which shines from east to west, north to south, and everywhere in the world, subhanAllah. It's a long, beautiful riwayah explaining the birth, and there are so many riwayahs explaining this. I conclude with one or two verses, which I love ending off with, where the poet says, The twinkle in my eye is the name Muhammad. The light in my heart is the name Muhammad. Allah, who is the greatest sustainer of all, has written on everything the name Muhammad. Names are found in Subhanallah, excuse me. It says, should you wish to achieve success in both worlds, then keep your tongue moist with the name Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. I give you the meaning for a change. Now I'll recite the poetry. It says, the twinkle in my eye. Akokatana name Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. تلك أجلاء أجلاء نعم محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم الله أكبر رب العالمين هر شيء ملكه نعم محمد دولت جو چاہو دونوں جہاں کی کر لو وظیفہ نام محمد صلی اللہ علیہ وسلم just for once together مولا یا صلی وسلم دائما آمین سلم دائما.